There! back!
Open it.
There!
Elizabeth!
You bet!
Got it.
I'll keep my eyes open for more.
Elizabeth?
Looks easy enough. There.
I had trapped the atom in mid-air. Colleagues called my Lutece field quantum levitation. But in fact, it was nothing of the sort. Magicians levitate. My atom simply failed to fall. If an atom could be suspended indefinitely, well, why not an apple? If an apple, why not a city?
Open this, Elizabeth?
That won't take but a minute. All done.
Here's some cash.
We need to get to Comstock House, Booker. Let's head back outside.
This? Back there at the shop, what you asked me to do.
Let's not discuss it.
No, what did that thing do to you?
If he were to take me back, that's death, Mr. DeWitt. Or something so like it, I cannot tell the difference.
Damage and release to throw it back. Hold and release to create an explosive trap.
I found a lockpick.
Would you rather be in the
Want to hold on to this? Catch, Mr. DeWitt.
Thank you.
be going to come back from this.
Maybe it shouldn't.
Thinking about that dream that you had. New York on fire. There's something about it. Beyond that gate lies Comstock House.
This is for the miracle child. Hello. I'm sorry your mother, Lady Comstock, is dead. I think she is altogether better than mine. Since you live there, can you tell me why the tower has been closed? People say it's poor weather, then the pox, then a haunting. If it is a secret, I promise not to tell a soul. Your pen friend, Constance.
Hey, Lady Comstock, how lovely to see you. Wonderful of you to make the journey, especially considering your painful death 19 years ago.
Lady Comstock.
The dress. The thing has mistaken me for my mother.
Your fingerprints do not seem to be your own today, Lady Comstock. Are you unwell?
This isn't going to work.
I think it can.
Your mother's dead, Elizabeth.
Yes. I think it's time I paid my respects. Let's head to where she's buried. There's the graveyard where my mother's buried.
Going.
Come on.
What are we looking for?
There it is.
Grave.
They have her preserved in an airtight chamber. Fingerprints will get us into Comstock House.
She's your mother.
A mother who abandons their child doesn't draw a lot of sympathy in my book.
Take a moment to think about what you're doing.
There. Will you open the door or do I have to go in without you? How are you, Mother? All locked up in there, huh? Looks like you and I have some common ground.
Let me do it.
No.
Let me do it.
Look on the other side.
Shepherd, and he has led you astray. What I do for love. What lion does not cringe to see their cub in pain? But spare the rod, spoil the child. If you won't listen to me, perhaps you will listen to your mother.
Elizabeth, are you all right?
Where did she go?
Just hold on. You need to rest for a minute.
No, I'm getting that hand.
Elizabeth, why is your mother a ghost?
She's not. He used me to power that device. He opened up some kind of tear.
Mother! It's raising the dead!
Souls! Cover, catch!
Thank you. brakes. Timing.
I can help you.
Is she alive or dead?
Why do you ask what?
When the delicious question is when.
The only difference between past and present
is semantics.
Lives, lived, will live.
Dies, died, will die.
If we could perceive time as a true loss,
what reason would grammar professors have to get out of bed?
Like us all, Lady Comstock exists across time.
I found some money. Alive, want it?
She perceives being both.
She finds this condition disagreeable.
Perception without comprehension
is a dangerous combination.
Look!
Footsteps. She goes to unfinished business.
We have to follow her. Convince her to open the gate to Comstock House.
It's a shame you have need of her to enter Comstock House.
Frankly, she doesn't seem all that cooperative.
There is a way to bring her to reason.
Three truths you must discover first.
Truths which, in this world, Comstock has destroyed.
If only one of you had the power to alter time and space.
That would be a blessing, wouldn't it?
Hmm.
Sarcastic.
There's something off about Lady Comstock.
Yeah, I noticed.
No, you don't understand. She doesn't belong here. I brought something through. I'm not so sure it was her.
Thank you. But you two are dead. I took your funeral photo.
Yes, and made an absolute hash of it.
One doesn't expect a picture of one's corpse.
To come across so lifelessly.
What did you mean before when you said Lady Comstock didn't belong here?
She's almost feral. It's like she's a reflection of... I don't know.
They've been dead these 7 days!
Ah! Some money. Want it? Cash. I wonder. Hey, there's a lockpick over there.
Down to the vault.
sabotage all their patents?
All of them, Mr. Fink.
Now, why does the Prophet want these two killed?
For the same reason Lady Comstock lies buried. Child.
And why does he want me to do it?
Because only you can make it seem an accident.
I don't think that's the real Lady Comstock. She's a combination of herself and my feelings towards her.
Archangel tells me that Columbia will only survive so long as my line sits the throne. Yet Lady Comstock produces no child. I have done what a man can do, yet there is no child. I've asked Lutessa about the matter, but even she refuses to help.
Want to hold on to this?
Open.
Okay. All done.
seems to have been made sterile by simple exposure to our contraption. A theory. Just as sexual reproduction can de-emphasize the traits of each parent, so goes the effect of multiple realities on our own. Your traits dissipate until they become unrecognizable or cease to exist.
I assure you, madam, my sexual interest in your dear prophet is non-existent.
And Madame Lutess.
Furthermore, the man is quite sterile.
It's a lie. Come here, you little bastard! I want her out of my house!
Sterile.
They were my parents.
Then what were you to them?
A child that he decided to imprison. I don't understand what... Why would the twins send us to find three truths? Were the tears somehow related through a kind of quantum field, or were they...
Elizabeth, we wanted you to understand her.
Who? You mean... Oh. All right, come on.
Anyone who knew the truth was better dead than alive.
I'm not even his daughter. I'm just some...
No, you are not. So listen to me. What you've been through, ain't nobody in the world deserves that.
Booker.
We are getting out of here, you got it? You're never gonna have to look back.
Rosalind Jess is not my mother. Neither are you. She killed you both. I know you hate me for not being your daughter. And I hated you for not being my mother.
Undo my suffering!
There she is!
Good.
Much obliged.
Open it.
On it. Still looking. Found ammo. Take this.
left.